But I would like to, am I allowed to ask him a couple of questions?
Senator Squadron, do you yield?
Of course.
Senator Squadron, part of our package that we have put forward would actually consider whether a political consultant should be permitted to register as a lobbyist. Legislation which would ban such practices previously passed the Senate. Now, there are different organizations out there that routinely use firms that do this. Is that something that you support?
The sponsor said that bill has been through the House, so I will look at how I voted on it and let you know.
But if it's something that, for example, you know, somebody, maybe you voted on it, but you actually are somebody who maybe would utilize that in practice, is that something that should be looked at?
Sponsor would clarify if I would utilize what in practice?
So for example, you know, if that's something that a certain group actually did routinely, is that something that you would be willing to denounce today then, if that's a measure that you support?
Sorry, if the sponsor would just describe the activity.
I'm just saying that that's part of our proposal, that whether a political consultant should be permitted to register as a lobbyist.
Whether political consultants should be allowed to register
right,
as lobbyists?
And then whether, you know, certain groups actually use lobbyists and political consultants that do both.
I'm having a little trouble understanding the sponsor's question.
Okay, so I guess you're not
going to answer it. I think those who lobby on legislation, resolutions, state action must
okay,
register
so
and
I guess
should
you're not,
re- that, register
that's
as,
fine,
as well.
Senator, if you're not going to answer.
As well, I'm, Mr. President?
Senator?
Thank you. As well, I think it's critical that anyone who is exerting influence in those kinds of direct ways register. In the case of this bill, the sponsor said a bill referenced in the resolution has moved through this House rather than us sort of try to find the right words for it. I said I would get my voting record on it and share it with the sponsor.
Senator Young, do you wish to ask Senator Squadron if he continues to yield?
No, I think I'm done. Thank you.
Okay, Senator
President.
Squadron, then you have the floor.
Thank you. On the bill.
On the resolution, Senator
resolution.
Squadron.
Thank you, Mr. President. I did that last year as well. Thank you for clarifying 2 years in a row. I'll see you at the same time, same place next year. Hopefully different outcome.
Take a vote on that?
Different places, just to be clear. Mr. President, when you look at this resolution and you look at the governor's budget proposal, there is a significant spending component, and of course that's a critical portion of what we do up here, critical and related policies. The budget is our opportunity to not just ensure the state spending is effective and efficient and makes the best use of the taxpayers' dollars. It's also an opportunity for us to really get at the core of our state government and how it functions. In fact, approving a spending plan well over $100 million, over $150, without also cleaning up state government and creating people's faith or recreating people's faith in state government is an enormous mistake. And that's what this resolution risks doing. We heard repeatedly about the pension forfeiture issue. To be clear, that is something that I have voted for. Many members of my conference as a whole has voted for. We believe that's important. However, that does not get at the core of what we've seen in the most disturbing cases out of this House and the other House in recent years. Since this time last year. This time last year, the former chair of finance and I had a spirited conversation about the destructive influence of the LLC loophole on state politics and government, on the fact that corporate entities should not be treated as individuals, should not have the ability to contribute unlimited sums. Subsequently, a significant corruption trial, federal corruption trial, on the former leader of this House and the other House proceeded, and lo and behold, the LLC loophole figured prominently. And yet, when it comes to fixing the LLC loophole, when it comes to doing something about the kind of influence, pernicious influence that it has, we're in the same place we were last year. We're hearing about the very, very weak tea of ethics reform that wasn't rejected from the governor in this resolution. But we're not hearing even a commitment to have public conversation about closure of the LLC loophole. We're not hearing even a commitment to have a public conversation about the influences of outside income. You know, if a fire is raging in someone's living room, you don't go into the kitchen and unplug the toaster. You go into the living room and you put out the fire. But that's not what's happening here at all. And the problem is that people's faith in our government has been destroyed, and it will not be able to be rehabilitated until we do something about these core issues. That's why, despite a number of good things and some other things I'm concerned about in this resolution, there is no way I can vote for a resolution that yet again is going to let a status quo that has done so much damage continue in Albany. Thank you, Mr. President.